Hi gang! This is a neat, easy to make heat engine, made mostly from a coffee bag. It looks sort of like a flower with flower petals. The petals straighten out on this side and curl back up on this side, causing it to turn. Here's the basic principle. This is the coffee bag I used, and here I cut a strip from it. It's likely made of aluminum foil laminated with some other material, possibly plastic. The foil and plastic are firmly attached to each other everywhere along their length. Watch what happens when I put it in air that's being heated by the hot water in the nearby glass. It curls up. And when I put it in air that's being cooled by the cold water in another nearby glass, it straightens out again. Why does it do that? It's very likely because most metals expand when heated, while most plastics contract. And when cooled, the opposite happens. Though in this case, it doesn't look like the plastic is expanding or contracting much, if at all. So in the case of the strip curling when heated, it's as if the foil is pulling on the plastic along the entire length. And when it cools again, the metal contracts, pushing it back together. Instead of starting with a straight strip, we can also give the strip a pre-curved shape. Here I hold the blunt edge of a pair of scissors against the foil side and press on the other side with my finger as I pull along the foil. Again, in the heated air, the foil expands, pulling on the plastic. But this time that has the effect of straightening it. And putting it in the cold air causes the foil to contract again, putting it back in its pre-curved shape. And that's also happening here with the flower-like petals. When a petal is brought into the air heated by the sunlight, plus as the petal itself absorbs the sunlight and turns it into heat, the petal is heated and uncurls from its pre-curled shape. That moves more of the mass of the petal away from the center of the rotor, and so that side falls. Meanwhile, in the shadow, the petal cools down again, and the foil contracts back to its pre-curled shape, moving its mass closer to the center. To get more sunlight absorbed to produce more heat, I color the plastic sides black. You can see a big improvement. Well, thanks for watching. Check out these other interesting videos too. That includes one where I show step by step how to make this heat engine, another about a corona motor, including some torque measurements, and one about a mysterious ball bearing motor that may also operate on heat. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, share with your social media, or leave a question or comment below. See you soon!